If you use a Mac and own a pair of AirPods, I'm gonna show you a way to use them and their tracking capabilities in any DAW possible, including in your Dolby Atmos projects. My name is Alejandro and we are the Audio Brewers. With the news update of AB Rotator for higher order signals, and thanks to a very nifty tool that you can download for free in the link in the description below, you can now connect your AirPods and use their head tracking capabilities in any DAW possible, including for your Dolby Atmos projects. Let me just show you in the DAW how you can achieve this very easily. So the first thing I'm going to do is download this application that is called Headitude. You can download it for free clicking in the link in the description below. And that's it. All I have to do is create an empty project and insert any type of audio file. I'm just going to start with an ordinary stereo file. So if I insert this, you can see that it's pretty much an ordinary stereo file. Just sounds normal. And now what I'm going to do is I'm going to encode this file to Ambisonics, then I'm going to decode it back to stereo, right? So to encode it to Ambisonics, I'm going to add our AB encoder. And I'm going to set the width to be 64 channels just to have the maximum resolution possible. And now I'm going to decode it back to stereo. I'm just going to set headphones. Right? So if I press play now, because the sound is being encoded to Ambisonics and then decoded back to stereo, it should sound the same. You have pretty much the same audio. And now here comes the cool thing. I'm going to add AB Rotator in higher order, and I'm going to enable its head tracking, and then I'm going to connect my AirPods to the Headitude app, and that's all you have to do, nothing else. So first of all, I'm going to add our Rotator. And I'm going to make sure that the rotator happens after the encoder and before the decoder, right? So pretty much the signal should be like this. First, the signal goes to the encoder, then to the rotator, and then to the decoder. And then I'm going to wear my AirPods. And now that I'm wearing my AirPods, if I go to Headitude, you can see that Headitude automatically detects that I'm wearing my AirPods and is receiving the data. So I'm just going to reset the orientation. And now if I enable the head tracking here, you can see that I'm looking for information in the port 8585. So I'm going to go to Headitude and I'm just going to put the port 8585. And as soon as I put it, you can see now that Rotator is getting the information of my head. So if I press play and rotate my head, you can see that no matter where I look, the audio always is kept in front of me. So the head tracking of my AirPods is being used in Reaper, thanks to the AB Rotator for higher order signals. And that's all I have to do. So what happens if I will have an ambisonic signal instead? Well, if I had an ambisonic signal, I don't need the encoder. So I will only need the rotator and the decoder. Let me just add an ambisonic signal here. This is a seventh order ambisonics mix. You can see the 64 channels here. And so if I press play, it should automatically work with no issues. Sounds awesome because this mix is already three-dimensional, so it doesn't matter where I look. Every time I look somewhere, I'm listening to new types of sounds that are happening around my head, on top of me, below me, behind me. Everything sounds so cool. So what happens if I want to use this to monitor a Dolby Atmos mix in Nuendo? Let's check it out. So right now I have my very simple Dolby Atmos mix that is ready. I have inserted a 714 audio file, which is going to my standard bed. Just imagine that this is a ready Dolby Atmos mix. Okay, so if I press play, the 714 file can sound in binaural mode. But I want to be able to head track the 714 mix. So what I'm going to do is bring this back to 714 and check this out. If I go to my audio connections in Nuendo and create a couple of output buses. First, I'm going to create a third order Ambisonics bus. And I'm going to leave this bus disconnected. This bus is just a bridge bus. It doesn't have to do anything. So leave it disconnected. And then I'm going to create a stereo bus, which is going to be the bus that goes to my AirPods. So here I should connect the outputs of my AirPods. And here I should connect the outputs that go to my speaker array. Right now I'm using the same, but if you are using something different, just connect here whatever is going to your AirPods and here what is going to your 714, right? That's all you have to do. If I go to my mixer now, you can see that now I have my standard bed, I have my renderer, and then I have the couple of buses that I have created. I'm going to lower the volume of my renderer so that when I press play, you cannot hear anything. And now I'm going to send my renderer to the third order Ambisonics bus. And I'm going to send my third order Ambisonics bus to my AirPods bus. So if I press play, now I will be able to hear the signal in my AirPods. And finally, all I have to do is insert the rotator in the third order Ambisonics bus. So I'm going to do that. And again, I'm going to enable the head tracking. And just make sure that I am receiving the information that is coming from my Headitude, which is already grabbing my head tracking and is going to my rotator. So if I press play, and that's it. This is how you can monitor your three-dimensional mixes using your AirPods. Right now, what I'm doing is converting the 714 signal to an Ambisonics acoustic sphere, and then I'm rotating it and decoding it back to my AirPods. It works really, really well. Well, if you find this video useful, don't forget to hit like and subscribe to our channel, and I will see you on the next one. Cheers.